All right, guys. It's Yuki, otherwise known as Dorothy. Thank you guys for waiting. Like I said, and as I promised, I'm going to do another route today. Yeah, I did. And thank you again, Mary. Now, as I was saying, I want to do another route today. And since one of our friends is a boy and also the Incubi brothers, we're going to do Matthew. And then if we have time, I'll do Naomi's route. But let's see. Anyway, let's get going, shall we? Onwards. This is a fictional interactive narrative. Any character resemblance to real life people are purely conceitual. Whatever. All right. So we're gonna go with Nyx, which in Latin is also called Yuki for snow. All right. Trinity Corporation. We're gonna fucking skip this. Me and you both, Naomi, skip. And then we're going to skip to this too. And we're gonna... Finally, I pulled back, and I was standing left there in a daze. What, huh? I couldn't tell what was going on. My mind was completely enwrapped by the kiss that melted to the depths of my forgotten memories. Oh, damn! Please forgive my brother. He's a bit reckless. And if I don't? I'm kidding. For poor James's sake, it's not a problem.
At least I feel a hell of a lot better than you right now. Because you used your abilities on her.
Sam! Dude! Just like, look at him! Isn't it like always up to him right there to screw something up here? Oh, crap. Eric!
Shut that pretty boy mouth of yours before I rip it off your pretty boy face. Jeez, you guys, can we not fight right now? All of us are in the best state.
There's our bae right there. Isn't he adorable? Alright. Enough fangirling. I'm gonna block you, Sam. I'm real sorry. Or wait, can I do this? I can do this good. I can do this. All right. There we go. All four brothers.
I guess you are right, Matthew. I agree.
What? I exploded. Alright, here's where the funny part comes in, guys. Are you ready? Here we go. What are you? What is going on? Why the hell are you in my house? Why are you all bleeding? You kissed me! Who are you? I couldn't help exploding after being taken advantage of and being left in a much estate. Yeah. My words escaped without filter. It definitely scared the man around me, even the guy who kissed me. Oh, shit. If it scares Sam, then you know you're being real aggressive. Holy crap. Wait a second, the guy who kissed me. Oh! We're gonna watch. Oh! Oh, shit!
What's your problem?
What's your problem? You can't just go around forcing people to kiss you like that? Are you some kind of pervert?
Pervert? It was only a kiss.
Oh, shit. It might mean nothing to you, but it meant a lot to me.
What? Was it your first kiss?
Tots. Shit.
Hey, what was that for?
I know first kisses aren't exactly amazing and full of sparkles, like out of a fairy tale, but I at least expected it more than just something forced on me.
So it was your first kiss. Stop making such a big deal out of it.
Are you asking to get punched again?
Well, what do you want me to do? It's not like I can somehow take it back.
Just because I can be an ass, we're gonna hit him again. It. Anyway, if you try to pull any fuzzy bits in the future, just a fair warning, I know Taekwondo. So what exactly are you all doing in my house?
Miss, please forgive us for our intrusion. We didn't know this abode belonged to anyone, nor did we have the time to take that into consideration.
What do you mean? You can't just barge into people's homes.
Escaped from a deadly fight that could have ended our lives. Luckily for us, your home was near, the windows were unlocked, so we quickly came inside.
Last I remember, the laws prevented strangers stepping on private property. Although, considering the severity of their wounds, it had to be serious. I guess that explains the wounds, but not why he kissed me. He had absolutely no right to do that.
Flustered lady. It's hard to explain, truly. We're not exactly normal.
Not normal? What are you guys, demons or something? I was joking, but the boy seemed to take my question differently. Look at poor Damien, he's like, yeah. Look at his goofy face! He's just like, yeah, you could say we are really, really much demons, but James, on the other hand, is just like, eh, and then Damien here is just like, oh god, do we have to explain? Anyway, let's go!
We're incubi, miss. Demons who consume and use sexual energy of humans. To survive.
Dots. Incubi. Demons. And make them sex-crazed monsters? The mystical beings that could look like just to get new pants? The imaginary monsters you only saw in movies or on TV?
Hello? Did you hear him? We're telling the truth.
Processing it?
Yes. She'll understand right about.
Right. That was funny while it lasted, but it's time to cut the joke short. Incubuses don't exist. There was no way they actually existed. That would be practically impossible.
Incubi is the correct plural. And yes, we do exist.
He's like, get it right. Seriously, he's like, just get the freaking part right. I swear he just goes like for educated women. Prove it. Oh no! As soon as the words left my mouth, I instantly regretted them.
Very well.
No! Damn it.
Very well.
Why could it be like, like Sam or something? Why Eric?
My
fuck.
You're so tempting with such non-beauty. Let me ease your mind with a tender kiss. I promise you'll enjoy every
minute. Oh my god. What? Once again, I was lost in a pool of calm and serenity, staring into Eric's eyes. I felt waves of heat course through my chest and onto my face, painting my cheeks red in their wake. I couldn't help but nod and agree to his offer. Shit. Yeah, okay. Damn it, Eric! Ooh, wow, alrighty. With another kiss, my heart began to burn once again in my chest, and my mind was sent spinning in the heated passion filled with pleasure. Once again, I could feel my body drain of energy as he kissed me.
All right, that's enough. Aw, very well. I feel so much better.
Fuck. Why? As he pulled away, I was left in a mental mush pool. I felt weak in the knees, despite my will demanding me to stand straight in front of the boys before me. The world around me began to spin as I tried to speak. I think I'm going to.
Where are our manners? I'm James, and these are my brothers, Sam, Eric, Matthew.
Shit. Sorry, guys, about my thumb being in the way. Dots. Alright. Fuck. Sorry about my thumb being in the way again. Okay. Ready? Here we go.
Miss, are you okay?
Look at poor Jimmy Man. He's like, what the hell is happening?
Shit. She fainted.
Sam! Thanks for stating the obvious. I couldn't believe Incubi real. It all spun around my head until I only saw black. Holy shit. Floating in the darkness, my mind kept replaying the scene over and over again, remembering my body of the touch of lips against mine. However, I began to feel smooth silk around me, and my eyelids unwillingly opened. Where? Become? Whoa! Whoa! Shit.
Ta-da!
I love this part. Sorry about my fingers being in the way, but look at that thing! What is that exactly? He smiled as if to wave it off, but then when he opened his eyes and saw what he was holding, his face rose in shock.
Wait a second. What did I just make? This is...
Look at that adorable whack-up job! Dots. What he produced from his pocket was a creepy-looking doll. Aww.
Oh, what is that?
I'm not sure. Look at the smirk on its face. All right, let's see here. His face paled considerably, and he dropped it onto the floor, scooting away frantically.
Get it away from me! You might be possessed by a demon or something!
Look at his poor face, he's like, what the hell? Dots, but is it he a demon?
That's not what I wanted to make! I just wanted to surprise you with a stuffed animal, just something to cheer you up. That looks like it came straight out of a horror movie.
He slumped his shoulders and looked down at his feet. Oh, it's okay. You don't have to look so dejected. I mean, it's certainly unique. I think I'll keep it.
But it looks so creepy.
It's a thought that counts, right? You wanted to cheer me up, after all. I picked up the doll and took a closer look. Sure, it seemed pretty weird at first, but it would be cuter from a certain angle. I gave him a small smile. Thanks. Ha! Huh, there we go.
It's good to see you smiling, even though the thing I made still kind of creeps me out. Anyway, you should come with me to the dining room. We're almost finished with the food, and, well, I don't mean to brag, but we're pretty decent chefs.
Sounds great. Lead the way. Something smells good. My stomach rumbled in agreement. I was starving.
Oh, the girl's awake.
Sam! Excuse you, I have a name, you know.
Should we really care?
He's like, should we? Because I really don't.
Sam, I will roast that tongue for dinner if it doesn't stop flapping in that idiotic mouth of you.
Shh. Whatever.
I apologize for his attitude.
Oh no, it's fine.
Good.
No. Again, if we be cool, that means that we automatically earn a heart for him or something or another, so we're gonna smack him.
That's going to sting.
Sorry. So sorry, I panicked. Yeah, sure.
No, I was expecting that.
Look at his face, it's so cute. Excuse me.
What is it, miss? Yes?
First of all, you can't use your powers or deliberately do something that might harm me or any other guest that comes over. We'll see for enemies, but you get the gist of it.
That sounds reasonable.
Second, you have to help me with my errands around the house. This place is kind of big, so yeah.
That is a generous offer, miss. Are you sure that would be okay? We don't wish to burden you any more than we already have.
It's alright, really. I mean, I started living here by myself, so I would appreciate some help around the house.
A wonderful idea. I live here and train while helping you with the house.
Look at Sam. So he's just like, seriously?
What? Are you serious?
Oh, damn.
Shh, be quiet, Sam. I haven't slept in a bed for days. Fine. But we're not staying here forever. Only until we can beat up that group of punks.
I think that is a reasonable time limit for our stay.
Yes, this is awesome.
Also beautiful, if you need a bedfellow.
Eric, no. I'll be sure to call Matthew if I do, but I don't think I will.
Eric, knock it off.
So what are we waiting for? Let's celebrate and dig in.
Finally, I'm starving.
Instantly, Matthew and Sam began to stuff themselves with the food on the table. I noticed James' eye twitching in irritation. Oh no, God. So I stifled my incoming laugh.
Really, you two? You're both acting like pigs. Oh, let them have a little freedom, James. It's not like we've eaten recently either. I'm sure they've been starving. Still, that's no excuse for stuffing their faces like backyard swine.
I almost couldn't hold it in. So I didn't. Hey, there's Matthew. I couldn't hold my laughter anymore as I laugh at Matthew and Sam looks my wave face is stuffed.
There's something funny? What are you laughing at?
I stopped to catch my breath. I leaned over the table and took a few deep breaths before replying. You both are so funny. Both of their shirts turned a slight pink before they looked away and swallowed the food in their mouths.
Shut up! We're not funny. We're hungry.
Well, we're glad that we made you laugh.
Shut up, Matthew! What? Just saying.
He's like, go to hell.
See, James, it's entertainment for her.
He's like, well, it's not entertainment for me, so.
They're your brothers?
All right. Now let's go to, I'll stay and help around the house.
Are you sure?
Yes! Why not? Matthew was cooking. Yeah, that sounds about reasonable. I walked into the kitchen and still looked over at Matthew, who was quickly slicing up strawberries and placing them into a nearby bowl. I walked over and looked over his shoulder to watch. Matthew didn't seem to mind. So I decided to ask him a question. What are you making?
I'm going to make a large batch of strawberry cupcakes. Aww. The strawberries are going to be the top pieces.
How cute. Oh, that sounds delicious. Can I help?
Yeah, I kind of hoped you would. Can you start by making the batter for the cupcakes? I put the ingredients and some directions on the counter over there.
I nodded before heading over the counter, where a string of ingredients and a small note card of directions sat at the ready. I smiled and began to work, mixing the ingredients and pouring the batter into cupcake tins to bake. I had to admit I made a little bit of a mess, but I felt like the cupcakes were still fine. There we go, now we just need to wait. As I turned to face Matthew, I noticed Matthew's red face. I tilted my head before he walked over and moved his hand a bit towards my face. He stopped, however, looking at me for permission. Not to him. Matthew continued to move his hand towards me gently, brushing a finger over my cheek. My senses tripled. His finger wiped over a small stain of powder and cream that landed on my face. All right. Matthew's finger was ginger and timid, wiping off the stain was with as little contact as possible. Lightning shot through my body at each wipe, running down my spine in jolts. Alright, so we gotta skip this. So it is all over me.
I'm so sorry about your grandfather.
Do you have college plans?
What do you think of the philanthropic policy the company had?
Do you think the company should expand from just toys?
This place is protected.
What did you say, shrimp?
This place has a seal. protecting it from hellborn magic.
What the fuck is that supposed to mean?
The previous owner had this place protected by magic, Malix.
Yeah. Malix, that was his name. His existence resorted in my memory from the dream I had. However, I looked to Matthew in the same condition as Malix did. This place is protected by magic?
It would seem that your grandfather had some sort of protective barrier around this house. From the looks of it, it only disables hellborn magic.
Malix's face grew to that of extreme anger, his fist tightening as if he was crushing a stress ball.
And what's stopping me from dragging your asses out and shooting you then?
Out of pure instinct, I stepped forward and placed myself between Malix and the boys. With no power, Malix wasn't going to fight. I took the chance to stand up to him and stop being powerless like I was in the dream. Fuck off. Malix suddenly smiled widely, staring at me in disbelief.
Whoa, whoa! Let the bitch out of her cage! What is this? The reverse harem or something?
Oh, jeez. Malix grinned at me evilly, walking close to me. Duck! I ducked underneath with Malix's incoming hand. I stared at his hand and his black flame tattoo in surprise as I took a couple steps back from Malix. Matthew and Damien stepped in front of me, guarding me from Malix with their arms.
A quick one. I'm liking you more and more.
Back off, Malix!
Don't start acting tough, you pathetic excuse of a demon! You need more protection than her.
Shut up!
Why don't you just grow up, eh?
Enough, Malix.
Okay, so we're gonna, explore the house. Well, come on, feet. Let's go on an adventure. I stood and excited in my room, hoping that the boys were still asleep. I began to wander the halls of my another house, opening each door to find each room where it led to. All at once, the boys looked at me, frozen in their movements. I just stood at the doorway, staring at them. After my outburst, James was the first to break away from the group, stepping towards me.
Good morning. We apologize if we woke you up.
No, it's fine. I've been awake for a while now. I'm sorry I interrupted.
It's quite all right. We needed to stop anyway. We don't want to overwork Sam.
Oh, come on, I can handle more than those pity punches.
Your mind seems grateful that we've stopped.
Shut up, Damien.
Crap, we should probably make some lunch. I'm sure you're starving.
I can handle lunch if you like. You all seem to be very busy training to beat Malix. I'll take care of it today.
Whoa, seriously?
Yeah, why not? I'm not useless. I know how to cook and do other stuff, too.
Well, no, I wasn't insinuating. What he means to say is that we'd be really grateful if you could make lunch today.
Haha, no problem. As I turned to the kitchen and the boys went back to training, they seemed very determined to get better and to become stronger. Might as well make lunch today. It's been a while since I cooked. Pizza. I quickly rushed back and grabbed a second dish before hunting down one of the boys.
Dorothy,
I looked down each hall trying to...
What do you think? I think it makes a cool crop top.
Wondering so that I wouldn't have to go through each individual room finding them, I pursed my lips in irritation. Where the heck are they? I sighed, knowing that I would have to search for them in each room. I quickly turned around, headed back to the dental one last time. When I arrived, I gasped. Aww. Matthew was crouched near the kitchen doorway, peering into it as if a rat had gotten loose in the pantry. And he was stalking exterminator. Matthew? I quickly shut my mouth and pressed my lips together in silence, confused but fearful as to why I had to be quiet.
He's in there.
What? Matthew's face was seriously fearful and intense. Who was freaking him out this much? My mind, however, instantly pinned the person down in my conclusion. Malix? Malix, why would he come back? Why was he in my kitchen? I started to freak out, remembering the fear I had the first time we had met. However, I wasn't sure where the others, if it was Malix.
I lost sight of him, but I quickly found him and cornered him in there. Now he's in there.
Who's in there?
That fluffy killer thing.
Fluffy killer thing? I bit my lips, suppressing a laugh. Once I swooled and I left her down, I let out a sigh. You mean your cute bunny doll?
Yeah, that thing. Wait, it's not cute!
Matthew instantly regretted not whispering and covering his mouth. I could not help but giggle. What's he doing in the kitchen? Matthew turned to me with an expression of utmost seriousness. Something told me that he would not said would be cute and funny, so I decided to bite my tongue gently to not laugh no matter what.
I don't know.
I failed to keep hold of myself and started to giggle, and then the thought of a doll doing anything but sitting there made me giggle. Matthew tried to hush me, waving his arms frantically to keep me quiet. Matthew, Simon's a doll. I can't do anything.
You named him?
He's like, what the fuck are you thinking? Of course, Simon Tabby. Cute, isn't it? Matthew let out some sort of defeated whine before turning back to the kitchen, trying to find Simon from where he was. I placed our food on the table and looked as well. So what's your plan of attack?
Well, I plan to make my way through the kitchen as quietly as I can. Hopefully not get stabbed.
Sounds simple. Matthew nodded in agreement before finally moving from his spot and tiptoeing into the kitchen. I stood there unsure of whether or not I should follow suit. Join the hunt. I don't know why I was up for this, but I followed along the small adventurous side of me. Very happy with my decision, but another side of me is questioning me, asking me why I did that. Matthew slowly walked to the kitchen, scanning the cupboards and surfaces with a malicious glare. It was both amusing and slightly frightening to see how serious he could be. Do all of your toys get out of control like this?
No, it's just this one. I don't know why. All my other toys are okay.
Other toys? Matthew nodded, stopping his search to look at me.
That's what I do. Make toys. I made them for my mother all the time back in the Abyssal Plains. To help her cope with her position.
Her position?
She's the fourth wife of my birth father.
Oh, damn.
Each of us have a different mother, and all of them, except for Damien's, are queens. My mom, though, hates sharing, so I distracted her with toys.
I didn't know what to say. A demon with multiple wives seemed natural, but I guess because I was human, I felt the tinge of disgust ran through my veins nonetheless. Still, it was adorable how Matthew tried to cheer up his mom with his abilities. I was then suddenly reminded of my grandfather and how he made toys all the time for kids. Matthew's power to make small toys instantly would have been so useful to my grandfather. I shook my head and began to search for Simon again. Let's keep looking for Simon. Matthew nodded before joining in. I felt like I was a comedy mystery looking for a child's toy instead of a murder weapon.
Come on out, creepy thing.
Its name is Simon. What? No.
Please?
No. You're yes. Not using it. Forget
no,
it.
I'm not planning on using it.
You have no messages.
Not that either.
What do you want? I can do both things at once.
Good. Picking you up. Come on, let's go.
Oh, hell no. Okay, no.
Yeah.
No.
Come on, I need to set an example.
Uh-uh.
No!
I
need to tell this douchebag that I will flip him.
Well, good. Try it in a different way. I don't want to be play doll.
You won't be play doll.
I said no. Matthew ignored my statement and began to slowly open the cupboards, shifting through the inside contents. I decided to follow suit, starting at the opposite end of the kitchen. Matthew, what do we do if we find him?
We stick him back in my pocket, and...
I looked to Matthew, waiting for him to finish replying. However, he kept his eyes to the ground, trying to answer my question and remaining in thought. I continued to search the covers, unsure if this was going to... If this was going anywhere. What was I even doing? This Simon Tappy was a... Holy damn it. What the? Matthew and I scanned the kitchen frantically, searching for the source of the laugh.
I knew that thing was evil!
Suddenly, everything went black. Who turned off the lights? I gripped to the nearby counter, not wanting to bite anything or fall in the darkness. There was no window, so the room was almost completely pitch black. I could hear skittering across the floor like a rat rushing to escape with its cheese in its mouth. I instantly jumped in fear before suddenly being pushed to the ground.
Watch out!
I felt myself hit the ground with my body on top of over top of me. Two hands were slammed beside my head onto the top floor. Oh, no! Stopping the person above me from crushing me.
Hey, are you okay?
Matthew. Yeah, I am. I stared up at Matthew, letting the situation sink in. We were looking for a doll, and now we were on the ground. What broke my thoughts was a flash of gold running across Matthew's eyes. I could feel a heat radiate from his body, but the air was... tense and his body was almost shanky. Is that really a word? Alrighty then. Matthew, are you okay?
I
heard him gulp, answering my question. He wasn't okay, I could tell, but he wasn't moving. Matthew,
sorry,
Suddenly a golden glow covered Matthew's eyes. I expected to feel warmth in my body from upcoming spell, but I felt nothing. Something was wrong.
I need you to push me off. I...
From the sound of his voice, he was definite to get up off and of me. Why couldn't he move? Oh, then it hit me. Matthew, do you need energy?
I do. But I...
Matthew shut his eyes, trying to hide his golden gaze from me. He didn't want to take my energy. Why was he ashamed to? Just kiss him. If he needed energy, I was willing to give it. I instantly grabbed Matthew's face and tilted his head to an angle with mine. How can you do that if you're in the dark and you can't see each other? Leaning in closer to him, I brought my face and lips up to his and kissed him deeply. I don't know if this would help, but it was how he got energy before. I shut my eyes, waiting for the draining feeling to reappear in my body. Matthew didn't move, nor did I feel energy drain from me. I opened my eyes and saw Matthew staring wide-eyed at me, but unmoving. He was unsure what to do, and I had silenced him in confusion. I pulled away and spoke. I want to give you some of my energy. You've used a lot of it, and I'm sure that the energy you took from me was only used for healing. Let me help you.
I really don't.
He's just like Sam with that line. Matthew, if you don't want my energy, just tell me. But I'm offering it to you if you do. Oh my god.
He just said he doesn't want it.
All of a sudden, I felt that familiar feeling of warmth run through my body once again. I felt my body slightly heat up as Matthew wrapped an arm around my body and pulled my body tighter to his. Matthew grew a lustful... Oh my god. A lustful gaze before bringing a hand up to cup the back of my neck. All right. Oh, damn! Look at that! Holy shit! Alright. Before I knew it, Matthew pulled me into a gentle but passionate kiss. Heat erupted through my body as his kiss slowly and almost timidly got deeper. Matthew kept an arm around my waist while I rested my hands on his chest. The energy from my body was slowly draining in the kiss, making me feel light and warm. It was almost pitiful how comfortable and how willing I was in this situation. Still, I had no regrets. I was enjoying every bit of this kiss. Matthew was full of surprises. As childish as he was, hey, he definitely was...
What's this box here and all this other crap in the living room?
You're going to kill me if you keep on interrupting my recordings.
What is this?
I don't know.
Mary?
Probably one of her old colts that can't fit her. As childish as he was, he was definitely was proving to be a man while he was kissing me. Matthew wasn't forceful, but his kiss was deep and passionate. It felt almost magical. Almost. Almost. It was how I imagined the first kiss to be like, except with the train, energy drain. Soon, though, the energy drain stopped, and Matthew gently pulled his face away to end the kiss. I stared up at us we both panted for air. I had never kissed like that. And before, I was so lost in the moment that I had forgotten how to breathe. Matthew moved a strand of hair from my face to behind my ear, eyes still full of desire. Matthew stared sadly at me, unsure what to say. However, I could tell that he was full yet yearning. I could feel the hold of his mind-altering spell fade away, but I still felt hot. Something told me that I wanted more, but at the same time, I wasn't sure if I truly didn't want to give any more. You know what? Just fuck it, keep going. I opened the opportunity, and I was enjoying it as much as he was. I wanted more, and I was going to let him keep going. I wanted to keep going. Of course you did. I leaned up and kissed him again. Matthew gasped against my lips, but continued to kiss back. I could feel him pull on the tail of my bow, releasing it and following his hand off from around my neck. He moved the ribbon to his pocket before gently unbuttoning the top two buttons on my blouse. The desire in my body drove me insane, forcing a moan to escape my lips. Oh, crap, as he ran kisses from my lips down to my exposed neck. As he began to ravish my neck and shoulder in hot kisses, I leaned my head back and let a pleasured sigh escape my lips. Matthew was ruthless in his passionate kisses on my skin. Matthew didn't stop at touching and kissing me, making more moans and gasps throughout my mouth into the open air. He may have been full, but he was as hot as I was. Oh, how I couldn't even comprehend how much time we spent making out. I was lost in the pleasure that I didn't care. Call it sinful, but I didn't care. I loved it. His touch, his kiss, his heat, his heat. I desired it beyond anything at the moment, even as he lowered his kisses down my chest, just above my bra. My heart was beating wildly in my chest. Something about Matthew intrigued me immensely, but something made my heart quicken for him. It couldn't have been love, but it was too passionate to be lust. What was it? However, I began to feel dizzy, seeing the ceiling start to spin almost wildly. I gripped to Matthew's shoulder, trying to signal him to stop, but my mind faded to the black before I could let out another sound. I felt good. I didn't care that I was blacked out. I felt warm and fuzzy in the darkness. I never knew indulging that kind of passion would be that good. Damn it! I now just waited to be awakened, hopefully in a good way. My eyes eventually fluttered open, adjusting to the sight around me. I felt familiar silks underneath me, letting me know that I was in my bed. I slowly sat up, stretching from the tiredness that I still lingered. I felt a very soft pain on my neck and shoulders, and I could feel my swollen lips pulse and gently in the healing. However, when I looked at my body, I saw that my shirt had been pulled back up and rebuttoned as if nothing happened to treat me of Matthew. Oh, wow. I was just missing a ribbon. Before I turned to get out of bed, though, I spotted my ribbon on the pillow beside the one I slept on. It was tied around Simon Tabby in a nice bow with a small note attached to it. I gently slipped the note from the tie and opened it to read it.
I'm really, really, really sorry. I didn't mean for it to go that far. Please forgive me.
Oh, I stared at the note, letting a small smile grace my lips. He went too far. I enjoyed it a lot. It was cute, though, to imagine him thanking me for something we both did and enjoyed. I brought the note to my chest, letting the memories of our meeting flood my mind. I indulged myself too, Matthew. Good for you. I looked to the time out of curiosity. The large white numbers on my phone showed 5:31 p.m. Yikes, 4 hours of being knocked out. And I still feel tired. It was Sunday, so I was allowed to sleep longer if I wanted to. The The remainder of the night passed by, surprisingly uneventful. The boys continued to train with each other, but were kind enough to stop and make me dinner. I was glad for that. Unsurprisingly, the food was perfect, but it felt a little empty without the boys to eat with me. They most likely had already eaten, but still I felt lonely. I couldn't let it bother me. I ate and went back to my room to study and sleep. Surprisingly, I felt good going to my bed that night. I felt like I could have a peaceful sleep after the previous rough nights I had. I felt good. Okay.
My name is Zaceru.
Matthew pulled away and smiled at me, despite still carrying worry in his eyes.
If you are in any danger, call my name. I promise I'll come and help you.
I stared up at Matthew, unable to say anything. I could only non-response. Matthew smiled before releasing my hand and heading into the dining room. Something told me that name would be useful eventually. And right on cue, Naomi drove up to the gates with Suzu waving at me down. I rushed down out the door, and we headed to school, talking about the homework and the coming day. Okay, so we're gonna skip this. Oh. Woohoo! Glare into Ursel, how about that? I glared at Lisette, feeling wisps of air and magic run through my skin and veins. However, I stopped at what I saw. Holy crap! Diane! Around the set was a dark purple aura. It seemed all too familiar. It was like demon magic, but it seemed to be Tamar. Around this, I slowly rose to my feet, collecting my belongings. As I continued to stare at the set, something was off. As I continued to look at her, the aura grew from her shadow behind the set with red eyes, like shapes glowing from within its darkness.
Anderson.
Alright? Dots. I couldn't respond. I was entranced by a small hum in the air. It was distant, almost like an enthral whisper you'd hear in horror movies, but it was real. It sounded vaguely of a woman humming a tune I didn't recognize.
Hey, are you okay?
Let's go. We'll be late for class. I suddenly felt the need to walk away, so I did. Naomi and Suzu scrambled to catch up and fall at my new quickened pace.
Sheesh, Anderson. You look like you saw a ghost. Are you really okay? That fall was pretty bad. I think she saw underneath Lisette's cake face and saw the devil itself. Oh, Suzu, hush!
Dots. You know something was wrong with Lisette. It was more than just her being mean. There was something or someone watching over Lisette. Or they were watching me behind Lisette. What were they doing? I didn't know, but it was definitely demonic. Zaceru! Zaceru! All of a sudden, a purple light engulfed the room, causing the devils around me to cover themselves.
What the?
As the gust started to die, the light began to fade, revealing Matthew with his hands shoved in his pockets and his head up. Matthew? Malik slowly moved his hands from his face, taking the sight of Matthew before laughing hysterically.
Are you kidding me? You summoned the crybaby, run!
Oh, shit. Alex's laugh was cut short. However, we stopped by his gasp of pain, the thud of something embedded itself into flesh. I couldn't believe it, but somehow a knife that had stabbed into Malik's shoulder caused him to grip at it in pain.
What the hell? A knife?
Oh!
I won't miss your throat.
Look at badass Matthew. Look at him. That's badass there. All right, okay. Max snarled before ripping the knife out of his shoulder and tossing it to the ground. He quickly raised his gun and shot at Matthew, resulting only to stare wide-eyed at his target. In mid-air, a knife and Malik's bullet clashed, and both collided to the ground between the demon and the devil. Matthew chuckled and pulled a hand out of his pockets. Holy shit! Revealing a handful of knives splayed out like a fan.
Too slow, Malik. Must suck being an old fart.
Malik instantly grew furious, charging at Matthew while shooting rounds at Matthew's shadow-covered face. Matthew followed suit, rushing backwards, and shot his knives at each of Max's shots. Each shot was stopped by a flying knife, making multiple clangs beat throughout the air. The remaining devils stared, trying to figure out what to do. Help Malik, or watch silence. Eris, however, walked up beside me and crossed her arms as she watched with an amused smirk on her face. As Matthew backed into the far wall, he stood still, tossing knife upon knife at the incoming devil and his bullets.
Gotcha, knife-throwing circus freak!
I saw a smirk go on Matthew's face before he hopped up and flipped over Malik's. The devil decided to stop, barely bumping against the brick wall. Matthew, however, didn't give Malik a chance to turn before shooting multiple knives into Max's back. Holy shit. Matthew tossed a knife into the air and caught it before chucking it at the back of Malik's head. The knife sadly didn't get to meet its target. As Malik ducked out of the way and turned to face Matthew with a face of pure rage. Matthew brought out another knife and tossed it up and down in his hand, unchanged in his cool, yet almost playful expression.
Little known fact, I just like having fun.
That's a load of bull. What do you mean for? Why? Are you afraid I'll kill you as a demon scum you really are?
Demon form? I didn't understand. However, Matthew broke my thoughts from trying to figure that out.
Mind closing your eyes for me?
Huh?
What are you babbling about now?
Before I could answer, the tissues suddenly went from the warm to almost ice cold. And at that moment, something in the air changed. The air instantly went from frantic to still in energy. What could have described in tone as the color in red quickly turned into a deadly mix of purple and blue as everything began to blend together all at once.
You asked for it, Malik. Now you're gonna get it.
My eyes never strayed from Matthew's face, however, even as it changed. His eyes began to glow a bright golden color as a dark blue circle formed underneath Matthew's bare feet. I stared at Matthew's skin begin to morph and shift, changing from human to something else. For some reason, I was both scared and incredibly intrigued to see this new form. Before I was allowed to see Matthew's new form, I wanted them to stay. I wanted him to stay. I merely smiled, staring at the man I had come to have feelings for. Before speaking at last, I would love it if you could all stay. The boys cheered tirelessly, but nonetheless enthusiastically, I giggled at the sight. It was cute to see everyone so excited, despite the tiredness that ran equally through our bodies. Today was a rough day. My home is your home, as long as you can still help with the chores. The boys nodded in unison, agreeing with the terms I had set for them. Despite the good situation, I felt myself slowly slip into consciousness. However, James quickly clapped his hands together, getting everyone's attention and waking me up, making sure I didn't pass out on the floor.
All right, everyone. We're all very tired, so let's head to bed, shall we?
Oh! Yeah, sleep is actually a thing. Right.
We've had a very long day, but it will be good to just relax tonight and tomorrow.
Sleep sounds really good right now.
Yeah, man.
A girl named Diana came by last night.
Diana? Is she important? Did she try to hurt you?
Is it too late to pick She's breakfast? A succubus. Huh? It's 2:22.
No?
So, she's come to try to bring us back.
She must really be desperate.
Well, what should we do now?
Nothing. She'll give up eventually.
Will she?
Huh? Sure. The boys continued to look at me as if I knew the answer to the question. Damn it, Damien! She said that if I told you, she'd make my life a living hell. She can't possibly do that, right? She's not a devil.
No, she isn't. However, she is a very powerful demon.
Damien, shut the fuck up.
Nobody
likes you.
Actually, he's the cute cinnamon roll. He's fucking adorable. I stepped up, gently pushing the boys away to face to face with Diana. I was furious, and she was about to feel my wrath.
Wait,
yeah!
I wanna do some voice.
Only on the story, Mary.
Okay. You are in my house. You are an intruder. You have no power here.
Oh, really? Do I have to remind you of the power I have, dear?
No, bitch. Shut the fuck up.
What?
Don't mess with it.
Okay.
With a snap of her fingers, my mind suddenly locked up and I felt blank. I could see the world around me, but I lost control of my body. The boys quickly reformed around me, with James gripping onto Diana's wrist in anger.
Thanks. That was fun.
Holy shit.
Or what? You'll kill me? I completely dare it.
Let me do it. I could use the workout.
Don't.
And why not?
She wants us to kill her. If she dies, then civil war starts in the demon world.
Shut up,
what
Diana.
The demon world doesn't concern us anymore. We live here now.
Oh, damn!
With another snap of Diana's fingers, I was released from her hold, almost buckling to my knees.
Well, will you all change your minds? I assure you, it's for the greater good.
I expect the boys to say no. What I heard was complete silence. None of the boys replied to Diana, which made me both nervous and fearful as to why. Diana leaned her head back a bit, surprised for a different reason.
No. Well, I see.
Mary interception, I would totally fuck Diana.
Was silence truly them saying no to her? I looked at the boys and saw the disobedience in their eyes, giving me my answer. Why would you say that?
I do for that.
She's a freaking blonde.
No, bro. That's a dirty blonde, aka
I felt my heart flutter, especially when my aunt landed on Matthew. He kept close to me, glaring daggers into Diana. Too bad they're not actual daggers, or that would be seriously freaking badass right now. I could feel that he was completely adamant in his choice to say. I don't know what, but I was incredibly happy to know he wanted to stay. Diana sighed and pressed a finger to her, into her temple, rubbing it gently.
Either all of you are playing a very convincing hard-to-get game, or you all must be out of your minds. Very well. I guess I'll take my leave now.
It doesn't matter what happens to the princess. If I was the mermaid, I wasn't going to let the princess take my prince away. Diana stared at me before smiling and turning her body to fully face me. That's not true. Once again, the class looked to me and Diana faced me with another smile.
Not true. How so?
The trade-off for becoming human was marrying the prince or turning into seafoam. However, she was also given the choice to kill the prince and turn back into the mermaid. The mermaid didn't because she loved him and sacrificed herself for that love. That is a story worth telling. Not some princess getting her way, but a tragedy that had fallen beyond a girl who only wanted love. The class applauded me with Suzu giving me her usual punch to the shoulder and Naomi smiling at my logic. Diana, however, finally grew an almost angered face at me. Oh, shit.
Interesting. So what you are saying is that the princess should be given no mind.
Oh, shit. The story is not about the princess. The story is about the mermaid and the mermaid should have gotten her prince.
Even at the risk of a kingdom falling apart.
Even if the entire world fell apart around them, duty does not overrule love, and the princess needs to realize this. Fuck you, Diana. Let the world fuck you.
Probably already did.
Oh yeah, more so than once. Dirty jokes. Dirty jokes by Dorothy.
Dirty jokes. This episode is PG-13.
Matthew nodded before he looked down at me, taking my hands into his.
I'm really sorry. I'm really, really sorry.
Matthew, it's not your fault.
No, please listen. I know that Diana and Malix have come after you because of us, so it's our fault that you're constantly in danger. If I hadn't convinced everyone to come to the human world, we would have never been attacked by Malix, hunted down, and brought you in danger and...
I quickly reached over and put my finger on his lips, stopping him from going any further. I didn't want to hear any more. Matthew, it's okay. I wanted to help you out. I offered to let you all stay. Nothing is your fault. I gently moved my hand and cupped Matthew's cheek, staring at him with concern. I didn't want him to hold guilt in his mind about this whole ordeal. Diana was desperate and she'd hunt anyone for them. It wasn't his fault. She was desperate enough to hunt them down. However, I grew curious. Oh no! No. Oh, then sure. However, I grew curious. So Matthew, you're a noble? Matthew looked at me and gave me a goofy smile.
I was once, but even if I had the title, I didn't really feel like a noble.
How come?
Well, I was the fourth noble son of the demon. With Eric and Sam ahead of me in case James couldn't fulfill his duties, there was no way I was getting the throne. So, I spent the majority of my time trying to make my mother happy.
Aww.
She was always unhappy.
By making her toys. Unhappy? How come?
Well, my dad was kind of... Well, he married four different women. Each of us came from a different mother. My mother was the last to be married and bear a son. The thing with succubi, though... is that they get jealous very easily.
So what happened?
The other wives got mad and scorned each other. It wasn't violent, but we never ate together for a reason. My mom, though, was too proud to have jealousy.
She was the last woman the Demon Lord married, so she felt important. She felt that because he stopped marrying, she had the charm to stop his marrying spree.
Matthew let out a small laugh, a hint of depression lingering in the breath he let out.
My life!
But then the Demon Lord took another woman, and she bore him a son outside of wedlock. Damien. The wives, including my mother, were furious. In response, the Demon Lord had a spell cast on them, turning them into spiritual orbs.
That's horrible. Matthew nodded, pressing his lips together in both agreement and sadness.
They could never have physical form, and they lost all their powers. They became slaves trapped in the Demon Lord's castle. However, they were kept alive to make sure their sons grew up to be competent demons.
I'm sorry. Matthew gently shrugged, letting a small, nostalgic smile grace his lips.
She taught me how to be a demon, though. Not just a demon. A grown, adult demon. I read books, I learned strategy, everything that James was doing under the Demon Lord's watch. Only, I trained with just my mother. She wanted me to surprise the Demon Lord one last time, and maybe take the throne away from James.
Matthew then reached into his pocket and took out a small mirror.
Here, I'll show you.
Matthew handed it to me and sent a wave of blue mist into it. It began to glow until it enveloped the room in a bright light. When the light had subsided, I was back in the main hall of the Demon Castle. I looked around, feeling unable to move, but I could practically see everything as clear as I had before. However, my focus gathered on Matthew sitting on the throne as if it was his and reading a book. For some reason, Matthew reminded me of James at the moment. He seemed engrossed in his reading. Reading each word and absorbing each meaning. Him on the throne surprisingly fit him. There was something about him.
This is an easy read.
Cocky Matthew. A saddened... Oh, shit. Oh, no. A sudden cry, however, echoed through the hall, forcing Matthew to stop, close the book, and stand from the throne.
Mother?
Aww. I looked around, confused at the cry and where it was coming from. It seemed to just echo through the room without any source of direction. Matthew sighed and placed the book on the armrest of the throne before he cupped his hands together.
Fly and comfort her, will you?
As Matthew opened his hands, a small bird with blue and purple feathers perked up from the hiding place. Matthew smiled before releasing it into the air. I watched as it flew off and glided through an open archway. The sound of its flapping wings faded into the air as if it flew farther into the castle. I could tell that Matthew was holding his breath. He must have cared very deeply for his mother. It was incredibly sweet. At last, the sound of crying stopped, making Matthew release a happy sigh.
There we go.
Matthew cracked his knuckles in approval and reached for his book. However, before he could even graze the cover with his fingers, the sound of pattering entered the room. Oh, shit.
You! What son? Away from the throne!
Quiet! All right!
Shut up.
What am I going to do with you? You're a child.
Oh, shit. Matthew glared at the servant as the servant quickly brushed the throne off like there was dust all over it.
The next time I see you on the throne, I will inform the Demon Lord. Understand?
Yes.
He's like, whatever. The demon servant continued to brush over the throne before knocking the book from the armrest.
I'm not cute. I'm manly.
Matthew froze as the servant quickly
patted over, and picked it up.
What is this? A book? Why do you have it?
I was reading.
You read? You don't need to read. You're never going to need knowledge for anything, fourth son.
Fuck you. I saw Matthew's eye twitch, making me grimace. This servant sure had a mouth. It was annoying at the very least.
I'll just take this book and bring it to the heir himself to read. He's reading faster than the library can provide.
But that's...
Raistro's next area of study.
The servant began to walk away, ignoring Matthew's glare of anger. The servant stopped, however, to look to Matthew to pound one more nail into the wound. Oh, shit.
Let's face it, kid. You have the smallest horns, the smallest frame, and the least amount of power among the noble sons. You'll never be like them, so just stop trying. Use your incubus powers on others who have a child fetish or something.
The demon looked up at Matthew, up and down before rushing off where he came from, wherever he came from. As the servant disappeared, Matthew summoned a knife and chucked it into the direction where the servant left. The knife embedded itself into the hard stone beside the door into the hall.
I hate that guy. Disgusting pig fawn.
Disgusting pig fawn. What? That was a pig fawn.
What?
An imp.
Are you sure?
It was a freaking imp. The servants are imps. Matthew walked over and sat on the foot of the throne, clearly aggravated. Eventually, Matthew stopped the magic, glowing the mirror and holding it in his hands before looking to me. Huh? You're scaring me.
I had hoped to show you my mother, but I guess the mirror wanted to show you something else. Sorry.
The servant is terrible.
Tell me about it. He served the demon lord almost his whole life. Ugly pig fawn.
Matthew laughed. Well, I laughed at the insult. It was good to see Matthew in good spirits, despite what is shown and what is happening around us. Still, it was sad to see that he was considered the child of the noble sons. He could read books of knowledge that his brothers hadn't read, and he seemed caring. It was insulting to see someone tear him down like that. Matthew smiled at me before pocketing the mirror.
Whatever. Thankfully, we got out of there, so I could be with my brothers like a normal family. No hierarchies, no politics, no pig funds, nothing.
I smiled. It was good that he saw the positive side. However, his face slowly turned to a sad one before he looked down at the bed. Matthew?
You've done a lot for me and my brothers, sheltering us, letting us continue to live here. It may not seem like much, but for us it's everything. But I don't want you to get hurt because of us.
I watched him speechless. Silence as Matthew lifted his hand, his eyes full of almost hopefulness.
That's why I'm sorry.
Matthew lowered his head in shame. I couldn't help but feel my heart squeeze with my chest at this sight. He truly cared. Matthew let out a small sigh before looking to me with a new smile. He hid his sadness well, but I could tell he was still upset about the whole ordeal.
All right. You need to sleep, and I need to make dinner. I'll wake you up when dinner is done.
Matthew gently pressed me back down onto the bed, and I resolved in what had happened. Steal a kiss. I couldn't let him leave without doing something. I quickly pulled Matthew down to me, lifting my head and gently kissed him, softly laying a hand on his cheek to keep his face close. Matthew stared in deep surprise, before hesitantly kissing my back, caressing my cheek, and slightly melting at the touch of our lips. A soft sigh escaped his lips before he pulled away with a smile. He gently licked his lip, making me go red in the face at the simple gesture. He let out a satisfied sigh before nuzzling my forehead.
Go to sleep.
And with that, he stood up and left the room, leaving me to rest at his per request. I smiled to myself before relaxing into the mattress. I suddenly tensed up. I felt majorly uneasy. Something wasn't right. I felt it in my core. She must be here. The thought of her in the house and feared the enemy beyond belief. I had to make sure she was not here. I quickly rolled out of bed and quickly left my room, wandering the halls, listening too closely. She was a demon, but I was listening very intently. There was no way she would have been able to sneak up on me. I know you're here. Where are you? I could feel myself growl. It wasn't a matter of fear. Is that she would take away the boys anymore. Her existence had lit a fire of rage within my gut, which only grew as each day went by. The feud was getting on my nerves, and I knew it would not end well for one of us. I was going to lose to that demon bitch.
Leave me alone.
My heart stopped. Diana was with Matthew. My mind flew into slow motion, playing fake images of Diana trying to seduce Matthew in my head to further fan the angry flame inside of me. I instantly followed Matthew's voice. I approached the grand lobby and followed the commotion to the dining room. The sound was echoing from the kitchen, so I peeked inside while hiding around the corner. I almost growled at the sight Matthew was holding to one side of the kitchen's island counter, with Diana holding the other side, looking to him with a smirk.
Oh, come on, Matthew. Don't you like games? A game of tag sounds so fun.
Not with you. Now go away!
I'm hurt. Wounded, truly. Did I go too far?
You went too far when you came here and attacked her.
Pity. And here I thought I was going to offer you the chance to become something better than just a simple incubus.
What was Diana going on about? More than just an incubus, she was insane.
How about becoming the next demon lord?
I froze. What did she mean, become the next demon lord? The boys weren't in the demon world anymore. They had no claim to the throne anymore. Matthew stared at Diana, which made me worried.
The next demon lord?
Well, currently, I'm the contracted bride to the heir to the throne. Since the throne is open, it's available to any son of the Demon Lord's line. Think about it. You'll gain the throne, the land, and a bride to continue your lineage with. Doesn't that sound like a perfect life for an incubus like you? You'll show your father and mother how grown up you are. That you're not just some little cute boy people can take for granted.
I could feel myself gripping my fist tightly in anger. How dare this girl try to convince Matthew to return to the demon world? He ran away from it. He didn't have to go back. He shouldn't go back. My mind began to wander. Imagine him saying yes, he would leave the brothers that followed to bring him back. He'd be trapped because Diana would make sure they could never leave. Matthew would be the new demon lord with Diana as his queen. And I'd lose him.
Like I would believe you.
You don't need to believe me, Matthew. You just need to come back home with me. I promise, you'll be respected as you were supposed to be.
I'm not falling for it!
Fall for what? The truth? The truth is that your brothers still treat you like a child, even though the demon world is far behind you. The truth is that your little human love affair is fleeting. She can never see you as a man. Just
that's
a little
bullshit.
Boy who wants to grow up.
Guys, she might have to pause for a second.
What?
I need to put you on my back.
No!
This person doesn't believe me.
It hurts when you do that to my back, Mary.
Just a quick one, I promise. Guys, she's gonna...
Damn it, Mary!
I didn't do that. Pause your recording.
What the fuck?
Stop it!
Oh, fuck.
Not going back! And that is final!
I'm not going back! And that is final!
Look at him, dude! He's so pissed.
I think I'm more photogenic.
I could
than
see.
You. Look at my tooth cap, everybody!
Mary, I could see Matthew's muscles tense and flex.
I couldn't. I think he looks adorable.
Wanting to attack Diana, the girl in question, however, took a deep breath and looked to Matthew with a pleading look.
You won't even return to your mother. She's been crying ever since you left.
Do not bring her into this!
Matthew glared as Diana circled the island towards him.
She begged me to bring you back. She wants you to get what you deserve. The throne.
I don't believe you.
Matthew then walked away from Diana, heading to the fridge to start dinner. As if she wasn't there, Diana stopped and leaned against the corner.
She'll never love you, you know.
I don't mind. I care for her.
The human girl? You must be joking. A human like her can't possibly provide you what you need. She's a human. You're a demon.
I felt the urge to storm in and shut her mouth. It would give away my position, but I wasn't growing extremely I was growing extremely tired of Diana. I decided to be assertive and quickly stepped into the room, rushing to be in front of Matthew. Diana and Matthew looked at me in surprise as I glared daggers at Diana. Get out.
Well, well, little human. You're awfully nosy in business that doesn't concern you.
It does concern me.
Does it? I don't think a human would understand the importance of this affair.
You're asking him to leave to be someone he doesn't want to be. That's not going to happen.
Oh? And what makes you so sure about that?
I love him. Diana stared in shock at my explanation. Was it not what she expected? I didn't care what she expected. I wasn't going to lose the man I had grown to love.
You love him?
Yes, I love him. Diana's lips twitched, the edges curling into an amused smirk as she stared at me.
So what? A human's love isn't enough to understand the situation. A demon can never reciprocate human feeling.
Both are surprised, however, Matthew stepped forward and put an arm around me, pulling me close to his body.
I love her!
I saw the confidence Diana had shatter in her eyes as she stared at Matthew at his words. I could see the struggle in her face to try and find some weakness in Matthew and me, anything.
A demon love a human? Impossible!
You heard me. I love her, Diana. I'd do anything for her. And she cares for me more than anyone in the Abyssal Plane ever had. More than you'll ever know. She makes me feel like the adult I'm supposed to be. And there's nothing you can do to change that. Ever.
Diana took a step back, physically feeling the sting of Matthew's words in her chest. She had lost. I could see it in her eyes. Diana grew dull as she glared at me and Matthew. It seemed almost uncharacteristic for her, yet it was something I was surprised to see from her face.
Very well. Fine. Vale.
And with that, Diana faded into the ground, into a purple pentagram, crossing her arms and almost looking upset. Matthew and I were then alone, left with the silence of the room. I finally let out the air I was unconsciously holding in my chest, relaxing from the ordeal. Matthew stepped to me and held me gently, surprising me.
Are you all right?
I nodded in response, unable to speak so immediately. After being surprised, Matthew let out a sigh. Relaxing in the embrace, I gently placed my hands around him, returning the embrace tightly. I could hear Matthew's heartbeat. He held me close in his arms, and I felt safe beyond words. Are you okay?
Of course I'm okay. I'm holding you.
I looked at Matthew, surprised at what he said. Matthew blushed, moving a strand of my hair from my face to look down at me.
You mean so much to me. You make me feel like more than just a kid. I've never felt this happy before with anyone, And here you are giving me every reason to love you. I love you so friggin' much.
Aw, Matthew! I stared wide-eyed, blushing like a maniac. Was this real? No way. This couldn't be real. Was Matthew confessing to me? Confessing his love for me? Matthew gently caressed my cheeks, staring into my eyes with a loving, almost hopeful expression. The warmth of his hand invited me to nuzzle into it. Closing my eyes, this wasn't a dream. My heart was pounding hard enough where I was sure Matthew could hear it. Matthew gently leaned in, closing his eyes. He stopped, however, remaining just a mere torturous inch away from my lips. He wanted me to show my feelings for him. He had let himself open for me to kiss him or leave him empty. The power I had was unbelievable. Kiss him. I loved him and wanted him to give him exactly what he wanted. I gently leaned in, letting my lips finally touch his. Letting my lips finally touch his gingerly. Matthew let out almost a surprised gasp from my lips before wrapping both of his arms around my waist, pulling me close to him. I moved my arms up and around his neck, feeling the kiss between us deepen to a heated height. My chest was pounding, making me feel and see the fireworks in my mind. Matthew was everything I desired. He was the man I wanted, demon or not. It was so all supernatural to fall in love with someone so quickly. Maybe it was the sense of magic I was thrown into. Maybe it was Cupid playing with my heart. Either way, I found myself melting at the thought of him being with me. I found myself combing my fingers through Matthew's hair, making the man hold me softly tremble at my touch. He gently nibbled on my lower lip, asking me to deepen the kiss between us even further. I usually teased him before finally opening my mouth slightly for him. His tongue gently danced with mine as one of his hands slid up my back and cradled my head. He gently leaned my body back, making me cling to him as the heat of our kiss rose higher and higher. Gently, though, Matthew slowed the kiss down and pulled away, staring down at me. His eyes burned for me, wanting me to melt and buckle in his arms. I could feel myself melt already. Matthew opened his mouth to speak, but a very small blush ran along his cheeks as he was reduced to shy silence. I stared as he tried to find the words to say in my eyes. I knew exactly what he wanted. He didn't need energy though, right? Are you?
No, I just...
I stared wide-eyed, feeling a blush on my cheeks grow. He didn't say anything more, but I knew what words would have followed if he continued. He wanted me. I was stunned. Was I that appealing to him? Was his passion really that deep for me? Matthew gently nuzzled my forehead, losing the blush, and finally being able to speak.
If you don't want to, we don't have to. I mean, it's up to you.
I could feel my mind go numb and purr at the idea of a moment with an incubus. He was a demon of sex, the purest form of lust and desire. My love for Vulcan, I would enjoy every second of it. At the same time, I was indeed inexperienced. Diana wasn't wrong when she claimed me to be innocent. Did I want to give the innocence, especially this early? I found myself forgetting the words yes and no. What could I say to him? I knew then what I wanted, but how to say it without breaking the moment. Okay, guys, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to save this here. And we're going to try seduce me first. I couldn't believe the two words that came out of my mouth. It made the most sense to tell him yes. I needed him. I wanted him. Those two words must have made some in him finally break. Matthew gently wrapped his arms around me and went back to kissing me passionately. I could feel the energy was about me, making me open one eye to see blue light glowing around us. When the light subsided, I was in my bedroom on my bed with Matthew above me. I stared as Matthew held a look of reflecting love. My heart skipped a beat simply from his gaze on me. This was okay. I wanted to see all of him. I gave myself to him. I gently guided his head to me, kissing him slowly and bringing him further into the mood. Matthew slid both his hoodie and his shirt off and tossed them to the side before cradling my head in his hands and kissing me deeply. I felt heat rise in my body, making me undo the underneath my collar and release the buttons on my own shirt. Quickly, I removed my shirt and vest, making Matthew stop kissing me, and stare in such surprise. I was suddenly in a bra, but I could feel a blush invade my cheek. My shy side began to fester in my mind. Did I really want this? To undress before a demon? No, this was the man I loved, yet I felt my innocence drape over me in almost shame. I needed to fight it. I quickly rolled both of us over to where I was sitting on Matthew's lap, staring down at him. Matthew sat up, looking at me with one of the most sexy smiles I had ever seen.
Oh, whoa! 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 Oh, ooh! Oh, damn. All right. Matthew pulled me down, knowing I was still shy. I began to kiss my lips over and over. Each kiss was his promise to keep me safe, keep me comfortable, love me. I kept my arms wrapped around Matthew, taking each kiss he gave and giving him my own kisses in return. I didn't know if it was the fact that we were both top nude or maybe I just craved his touch, but I didn't want to let him go. However, he held me. I could slightly feel the shimmer of his hands. Was it his first? He wasn't going to tell me. He wanted me to enjoy this moment, but he was afraid of screwing up. His shimmering hands showed me his emotions perfectly. As he laid me down and knelt over me, Matthew smiled and finally embraced me as we both desired the pleasure between us would be heavenly and we'd go through it together. I closed my eyes and gave myself to Matthew. My body, my mind, my soul, it all belonged to him as he held me. His body, his mind, his soul, it all belonged to me as I gave into his embrace. His kisses and fingers over my skin would forever engrave themselves into my memory as our passion rose through the incredible heights. Our breaths and moans to each other equally sounded and echoed like a blissful chant we never wished to end. We kept moving, loving, feeling every inch of our bodies until we had enough, and I was enveloped in his embrace. Skin to skin, heartbeats matching, we held each other in the glow of the aftermath. I nuzzled my head under Matthew's chin as he held me close.
I love you.
I love you too. Just to hear those words come from Matthew's mouth made my heart flutter. To hear me answer made my soul warm and glee. I could feel both of us sink into a peaceful sleep together. It was the best sleep I had in days, and I was happy. I had love, and I had my happiness. My life was simply perfect. When I opened my eyes, when I opened my eyes, I found myself staring into Matthew's bare chest. I blushed, but looked up to see Matthew still sleeping. His sleeping face made me giggle softly, but the reality of the situation made my heart flutter. I couldn't believe it. I was lying next to a man I had grown to love with all my heart. His warm embrace made me feel safe, and as tender as the moment we just shared replayed in my head, I couldn't help but smile, snuggle into his chest. Unconsciously, he held me tighter to his body, giving me more of his warmth. I didn't want to move, but then my core suddenly tightened and made me sit up without waking the man next to me. I felt my legs move and bring me to my balcony window, where I opened the glass and stepped onto the patio.
Before you get all huffy,
Dimitri. I didn't come here to take your precious man away. By the way, how was it exactly? Demons are the best lovers, after all.
I glared. What do you want, Diana?
Well, I just wanted to... I'm giving you... Just because I can...
Absolutely not. Diana decided to step up onto the railing. Wasn't I expecting was her lifting me into the air. I tried to scream, but my voice suddenly became blocked in silence. What was Diana doing? Diana made me float over to her, and she smirked as we touched noses.
Well, if I can't return home with the boys, I might as well return home with the power to fight back. May you never regret your choice, human. If you do, I'll happily come and take it away.
I did, and I will never regret it for as long as I live. I walked back inside and gently crawled back into bed. Within the embrace of the safest arms I knew, I snuggled close to the warmth. Before closing my eyes, I was happy. Matthew must be baking again. I tiptoed over and peeked into the kitchen, wanting to know what was he making.
Almost done.
I watched as Matthew started to decorate an already wonderful looking cake with blue and white frosting. It looked delicious. I was practically salivating. However, as I watched him, I smiled. He looked so concentrated in his work. It was adorable.
And there! Perfect!
He stepped from the cake, allowing me to see his masterpiece. It indeed was perfect. I wanted to taste it soon. That looks amazing, Matthew!
What?
Matthew quickly turned to me in surprise, trying to hide the cake as I laughed.
I'm not done! I mean...
Matthew! I walked over and smiled, giving him a kiss before walking around him to the cake. Closer. It looks all more scrumptious. What is this for?
Well, I mean, it's for something pretty important.
I looked at Matthew Risen and I as he wrapped an arm around my waist. What is it for?
Guess! I'll give you 3 chances.
Or what? What if I don't get it right?
Then the cake is all mine.
He sounds just like Mary. I'll only give you 3 choices, and if you screw up all of them, it's all mine. Hey, no fair. Instantly, I wanted to pull away, but Matthew left and dashed some whipped cream on my nose from a nearby decorating spatula.
It's totally fair. Now just guess.
Is it your birthday? Matthew shook his head.
Nope. Second guess.
Is it an anniversary? Matthew nodded, but before I could cheer, Matthew retained his hand, gesturing to continue.
Anniversary of?
I puffed my cheeks like I could memorize facts and lessons, but dates were bad. It was like asking a girly girl when her boyfriend's frat party was. Matthew laughed before I kissed my cheek, making my puffed cheeks deflate.
It's the anniversary of when we first met.
I had practically forgotten he was right. It had been a couple years since I moved in, and met Matthew and his brothers. He threw a party last year, but how could I have forgotten? Time definitely flew. Matthew smiled at me, making my heart flutter and squeeze once again.
I want to celebrate it every year in a different way. Next year will be something extraordinary. For now, though, this cake will do.
I quickly pulled Matthew's head down with my hand and kissed him sweetly. Wanted to show my appreciation with a kiss. He stared at me as if his greatest wish had come true. I fought back a giggle at the sight. Matthew gently pulled me to him, hugging me to his chest. I snuggled into Matthew's chest, hearing his gentle heartbeat and memorizing his temple. I love you too. Before I could finish, suddenly the cake, which had been sitting silently and peacefully on the counter. Oh no. This is so hilarious. Exploded into a giant mess on it. Matthew luckily was quick enough to pull us back before we got hit with flying cake pieces.
What the?
I looked at the cake to see a very mischievous little creature standing over the cake. Triumphant add to what it had done. I began to laugh as Matthew's face grew red. As Matthew grew red-faced.
Simon Tabby!
I quickly rushed over and grabbed Simon to make a squeak sound noise in my hands. It was still giggling as Matthew came over and glared daggers at the white tall covered in cake. Aww. To calm Matthew down, however, I stretched up on my toes and kissed him softly on the lips. Matthew stared, but kissed back, not wanting to let me go without a kiss of my own. I love you, Matthew. Matthew sighed before smiling down at me, finally calm.
I love you, too.
I didn't want to wake up if this was indeed a dream. I felt light as a feather, not wanting to ever let go of the man in my life. There was no words that could describe the emotions within me. I felt joy, happiness, ecstatic, high all at once. Here I was with the man I would be with forever, with a cake I would delight in, even in pieces. I had gained the heart of a demon, no, of a man I loved. I vowed to cherish him and love him for the remainder of my days and beyond. Could a demon love a human forever? I knew Matthew could. And that was my happily ever after. Matthew's cake! Alright, so we're gonna load. Here. Say yes. Alright, so here's the second part. Hold me. I wasn't ready, but I still wanted to give him the love he wanted. Holding me close was all I needed, all I wanted. Part of me grew fearful of what Matthew would think. Would he hate me? Would he regret giving me his love? So many stories ended up when sex was given, and I didn't want this story to end. Matthew, however, smiled and caressed my cheek happily in response, nodding in understanding. I could tell that he was okay with my decision, which made my heart flutter in joy. Matthew gently leaned in and kissed my lips once again, wanting both of us to cool down from our passionate high. I kissed back sweetly, feeling the heat in my chest die out peacefully. Matthew pulled away slowly, looking into my eyes to reveal a deep love that haunted his blue eyes. Irises.
Alright, let's get you back to bed.
Aww. Matthew then wrapped an arm around my shoulders and lowered his other arm underneath my knees. I easily held on him as he lifted me up like a blushing bride and carried me out of the room and back towards my room. Matthew was kind enough to know my limits, and I trusted him to respect my choice. He wouldn't enthrall me to go out against my wishes, nor would he force himself on me. He was perfect. Matthew gently lowered me to my bed before petting my head with a loving smile. I was beaming in happiness. I didn't want it to end. As Matthew turned to leave, I quickly grabbed his arm. Wait. Matthew froze and looked at me, awaiting my next command. He was going to obey no matter what I said, but he was anticipating what I was going to ask.
I could see it in his eyes. However, I just wanted him to be with me a little longer. I didn't want to rest alone. Hold me. I repeated my words, holding another meaning to those two words. Was he okay with what I wanted? It was too close to what he had asked for, but it wasn't going to what I beyond what I desired. Matthew took in my words and smiled, and before turning back to me and sliding into bed with me, I was surprised, but I happily melted into Matthew's arms as they wrapped themselves around my body. I rested my head against Matthew's chest, enjoying the warmth it provided as I closed my eyes. He truly loved me as I loved him. My rest with him, as peaceful as could be, the best sleep I had in days. When I opened my eyes, I felt Matthew still holding me. They had fallen asleep. His sleeping face made me giggle softly, but the reality of the situation made my heart flutter. I couldn't believe it. I was laying to a man I had grown to love with all my heart.
Before I will...
Why frickin' Diana, though? No. Absolutely not. Go. Oh, it still ended that way. That was a good ending. Alright, guys. See you next time. And next time, I swear to you, it's gonna be Naomi's route. Bye-bye. Actually, I'll do a slideshow real quick. Alright. Okie dokie, so here we go. Since this is gonna do a slideshow too in this, I figured why not? We'll add some music to it since I get bored anyway. No thanks. We're gonna see some of my stuff. My pictures to be exact. Okay, so we're going to start off with videos. Not videos, but photos. I know you so better than the city and the review. I drive to
There's my little Swat. Swat's my dog, so.
He's freaking adorable.
Oh my gosh, isn't he the cutest?